Finally tonight, long before Facebook and blogs, there was a citywide print publication giving teenagers the opportunity to be heard and trained as young reporters. Our own Marlene Peralta was one of those teens who took advantage of its writing program.
She recently went back to this organization that just marked its 30th anniversary, empowering inner city teens with the power of writing.
Oh, you guys look familiar. Have you been on the cover of the magazines?
Youth Communications has been giving a voice to many of New York's inner city teens for 30 years. The program began in 1980 when youth programs were impacted by the city's economic crisis.
The city had almost gone bankrupt a couple of years before, and there had been massive cuts to education and youth programs, all kinds of programs that served young people. And unlike teachers and cops and firefighters, all of whom had a voice to talk about what was happening around the budget cuts and to fight back, young people didn't.
As a result, New Youth Connections magazine was born as part of the writing program.
Usually our writers come to us because they have something to say or they have an opinion or an experience that they want to share with readers.
I want people to, well, kids like me, high school kids, middle school kids, to just see that we're all alike and we have similar stories, similar backgrounds, and for them just to relate to me.
Many stories are incredibly personal, often impacting the entire teen's family.
I've had writers write about things like growing up in abusive homes, dropping out of high school, being pressured into having sex, their parents divorcing, all of these very big, heavy subjects.
There were a number of kids who wrote for it who were in foster care, but those kids were undercover. They wouldn't disclose the fact that they were in foster care to other kids on the magazine, even though they would let the adults know sometimes. And it struck me that if something was that stigmatizing, it was probably damaging for the people who felt the stigma, and that we should try to do something to bust it, to make that voice heard.
In order to do that, Hefner launched Foster Care Youth United magazine. Its name later changed to Represent. James Badrig is one of his writers. His experience about growing up without a father is one of the many stories that has made it onto the cover of the magazine.
It was a kind of sad experience, but when she introduced me to him, I was kind of like, I didn't really know him. He was kind of big, tall. I just didn't really know what to do. I didn't even really know I had a father until she introduced me to him that day.
New Youth Connections currently has a circulation of 75,000 through the high schools, so lots of teenagers see it. In fact, we almost never do recruit, because if we recruited, we'd have too many people. And that speaks to the fact that there aren't very many high school newspapers left. This is one of the few opportunities that young people have to do this kind of writing.
Despite this constant stream of talent and Youth Communications' wide circulation, the program is having trouble finding funding, especially now as journalism moves into the multimedia world.
Some of our biggest supporters used to be, Time Warner used to be our biggest supporter, but they only fund video now.
Other benefactors request performance evaluations that Youth Communications writing program doesn't have.
Funders nowadays want to see very simple outcomes. Did the student increase their test scores as a result of this intervention? And we can't show that, even though it's probably true.
However, those challenges have not stopped the program from expanding.
We now include teacher guides for all of the magazines. We reproduce the stories in books that can be used easily in classrooms long after the magazines have, aren't around anymore.
Moving forward, Hefner's organization is analyzing ways to reach its audience electronically. Marlene Peralta for Independent Sources.